What's up, everyone? Welcome to What Would Zig Do Gaming. I am your host, Zig, and I am here with Batman, a Telltale game series. So, I'm really excited for this. When I started playing Telltale games, when I got the Walking Dead Telltale game, which if you haven't played yet, go out, try it out, or go check out a Let's Play if those kinds of games are not your thing to play, but at least experience the narrative. It's amazing. Anyway, so When I was playing The Walking Dead, and then later A Wolf Among Us, which is also based off of another comic book series, just like The Walking Dead, I thought this would be a really great medium for Batman. And here's the reason why. Like, we've all played the Arkham games. The Arkham games were very, very good. Don't get me wrong. I loved Arkham Asylum and Arkham City. I haven't gotten around to playing the other two yet, for various reasons. But those games focused a lot on the open world aspect, which was awesome. The combat system, which was amazing, fluid, fantastic. But the detective segments and everything were, I mean, they weren't well fleshed out, which is fine because that's not the kind of game it was. But you have to remember that one of Batman's monikers, one of the names he goes by, is the world's greatest detective. So, like, later in the series, like, especially with Arkham Origins, I think was the prequel one, where you could reconstruct the scenes, like, they kind of went into that, but that game itself had a lot of issues with it. So here, they can finally look into that kind of aspect. Not that the narrative in those games was bad. I mean, the story in Arkham Asylum and Arkham City was really good. But here they can focus on the narrative parts of Batman. And the narrative parts of Batman have always been just as good as watching him swing in and punch people in the face. I mean, I think more so than any other hero in the DC comics, because he's not Superman. He's not Wonder Woman. He doesn't have this amazing plethora of powers to pull upon. So he has to be smarter about it, which leads to narrative. And when you think of, like, the best narrative stories in the DC comics, usually in some way they involve Batman. Death in the Family, Killing Joke, Dark Knight Returns. These stories are iconic for a reason, and it's not because Batman was breaking people in half, it's because of the feelings and emotions that are elicited because of what's happening on the page. And now we get that in a video game, and I'm really excited to try it out. So, if you haven't watched my Game of Thrones video yet, here's what Telltale games are. Or if you're not familiar with Game of Thrones at all, they're narrative-driven games. Point and click, basically. It's the new thing. It's the new evolution of the old-school point-and-click, like, mystery and drama games. Very light mechanics, very heavy on story, but they are usually fantastic stories. Their writers really know what they're doing. It's very similar to, like, Heavy Rain or Life is Strange, games like that, where you're really, like, fight scenes are choreographed, or whether they're done through quick time events rather than, like, controls or anything like that. So it turns into a really interesting experience. Like, you don't have to focus on the button combinations. You can sit there and watch what is happening on the screen and kind of get into it, and every now and then you have to push a button. A fantastic concept for a Batman game, because it lends itself so well to the type of character he is. So anyway, we're going to be getting started here. Let's go get started. Episode 1 just came out, so it's going to be a while until we get episode 2 out. Because there is no episode 2 yet. So let's see here. Episode 1, Realm of Shadows, purchased and installed. I don't know what this is. We'll look into that later. Bruce Wayne navigates the treacherous waters of Gotham politics as a series of shocking allegations surface while Batman confronts Gotham's most notorious crime boss, which makes me think either the Marconis, the Falconis, or the Black Mask. I don't know anything about the story. It's spoiler-free for me, so this is going to be a blind Let's Play. We are going to be doing it as the episodes release. Do we have a release date on episode 2? No. So, that's what we're doing. So, we're going to go ahead and get all the settings set up and get ready to roll, and then we'll be back in and ready to go. So, give me one moment. Okay, so, here we go. Don't mind the live thing up here. That means that I am broadcasting this to somebody. Somebody is currently watching the broad... Go away. One moment. Okay, so we're back. Don't mind the little live thing up here. I'm showing this off to somebody that is interested in the game. They haven't purchased it yet, so they're gonna sit in and watch. No audio or anything, so they're just gonna be in the background. But if you were wondering why it says live up here, that's why. So let's get into it. Episode 1. Start. What the fuck is this? Select a Bat-Tech color. Your Bat-Tech color determines the look of Batman's gadgets, gears, and UI. Okay, I can dig that. Let's see here. Blue, red, yellow. Yeah, we're definitely going purple. Fuck yeah. That's pretty fucking cool. I like that. All right, here we go. Maybe. Possibly. Here we go. Yeah. I'll talk about that at the end of the episode. Wow, this looks much prettier than any other Telltale game ever. City Hall, 8:32 p.m. Okie doke.
Hey, what are you?
Holy Christ! Well, way to start things off. Holy shit.
Get it open. On it. Hey, you think he's gonna show? He'll bring the whole goddamn place down.
Stay focused.
We'll be out of here before anyone can stop us.
Oh, really? Dude, you can even see brain matter. Jesus.
The hell?
Get back. Gordon. They're on the 52nd floor. I'm going in.
Hey, that's why
wait.
We know it. Okay.
Want him dead. Hey, you ever seen him?
Yeah, Gotham Zoo. With all the other flying animals.
Huh? I really should have let that go. Maybe I would have splattered against the wall, the window. That would have been awesome. What's
You can't keep doing this.
What's going on here?
I have to. No one else will. Every drop of blood, everything you've sacrificed, the city is safer now. It's made you a target. And people will keep you in the crosshairs until you're shot out of the sky.
Criminals in this city, they need something to fear.
Whoa!
Shit! The hell did he go?
Whatever got in, don't let it get out.
Hmm.
What was that?
That's a new mechanic for these games. Actually, no, it's not. The interface just looked a bit different. What's going on with the... What was the point of shift in that? Dun to dun dun.
I know you're trying to create a myth, but be careful you don't turn into a monster. Sometimes you need a monster.
Come at! Come on! Come on!
Yo! Oh! Nice. Oof.
Didn't your mother teach you to knock? Behind you, big boy.
Yeah, get after her! Oh, what a bitch!
Stay where you are! You're under arrest!
Fuck you!
If you want to be intimidating, you're succeeding. Criminals are becoming afraid of you, so are the police.
It's a scare tactic, Al. Just a performance.
Al, since when does he call Alfred Al?
Without a scratch.
So far. That doesn't belong to you.
I was wondering if we'd cross paths.
You broke the law. Here I am.
Cut the shit. The law. Don't tell me that's why you do all this. Squeeze into a suit, tie on a cape. Most people dressed up like that end up in Arkham.
Gotham needs a hero. Someone to hunt down people like you.
So that makes me, what, a villain? Sounds fun. Gotta admit it, though. You give a good chase. One day you might actually catch me.
Tonight.
Don't you know not to corner a wild animal? It's dangerous.
Then let's put you in a cage.
Bring it, Bat.
Oh, These QuickTime events are... Well, quick. You bitch! What the fuck? Oh,
it's over.
I wouldn't be so sure.
Good play. Oh, nice shot.
Well now, Jesus.
I got it.
Wait. Do not shoot.
Oh shit. Oh. Interesting.
Why go to all that trouble for this?
Shit.
A myth can't be killed. You, however, are flesh and blood.
Oh, shit!
Damn it! I said don't shoot!
Motherfucker!
No, wait!
That fucking cop is a dick! Oh! Uh-oh. Nope, let her fall. Actually, I should have and seen what happened. Because fuck her.
Guess I was wrong about you catching me. Not sure if it was for my sake or yours.
Who put you up to this? Answer me or I let go.
But you won't. You're not that kind of guy.
Yo! Okay, next time I do let you go.
Step out of the shadows and be Bruce Wayne tonight.
Oh, that's a much harder fight.
Don't let tombstones be your family legacy.
Well then, time to save the city.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. A humble district attorney like myself is not used to such a ringing endorsement. Even one who cut Gotham's crime rate in half. For too long, this city has burned with corruption and greed under Mayor Hill's authority. But I promise you, a vote for Harvey Dent is a vote to finally put your foot down. And together, we can stamp out the fire and save our great city. If only Mr. Wayne, my campaign's largest backer, could have heard that applause, he would... Well, there he is. Fashionable and fashionably late, as always. Say hi, Bruce.
Hi, Bruce.
Well, I tee him up and he knocks him down. That's how Mr. Wayne and I do business. Thank you. Thank you again, everyone, for your unwavering support. Together, we will change Gotham. Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us. Now, I know this is the biggest mansion in Gotham, but I don't think you got lost on your way here.
Where were you? I know you prefer the brooding billionaire angle, so the sooner we make nice with the donors, the sooner everyone will leave you alone.
Just working the night shift.
Yeah, well, then you're pulling a double.
No one came here tonight to see me.
Some champagne.
They want to see the Bruce Wayne, am I right?
And I can see him just fine from here.
This shouldn't be painful. It's not a kidney stone. It's only a little FaceTime with potential donors. Your face, specifically, with a mouth that's saying, "Support Harvey Dent."
We're the grease, they're the wheels. And they're rolling in enough cash and votes to help make Gotham a place for families again.
Ah, a little liquid courage before facing your adoring public.
This'll help you too, Bruce. Once I've turned this city around as mayor, you'll be a hero for funding my campaign.
Now all I need is a decent slogan. I'm terrible at those. It always makes me sound like a used car salesman. Which, for the record, I have not been since before law school.
All right. How about, a new face for Gotham? Hmm?
Look at you. That's not half bad. I'm gonna use that.
Bruce, you know what I said. Together, you and me, we change Gotham. A city free from crime, where children can play in the streets again.
That's what I want too, Harvey, but you know how rough it is out there. We have to shake things up to make that happen.
Well, we can start with a few hands, hmm? Come on.
I just want to point out all of the subtle allusions and foreshadowing that went into that conversation. A new face for Gotham that's not half bad. That was incredible. I would say spoiler alert, but if you're not familiar with Batman at this point, I mean...
Mr. Wayne, I'd like to introduce you to Bob and Regina Zellerbach. Of course I know these two.
Hello, Bruce.
Regina here is the chairwoman of Wayne Enterprises, and her husband...
voted for Mayor Hill last time. I'll admit it, Mr. Wayne. I don't know Mr. Dent from a pothole on Main Street, but I trust your family. If you believe in Dent, we believe in you. After all... whoever you support is a reflection on you.
And we trust someone like you to lead this city to greatness.
Well, thank you. But we're all here tonight because we want to make a difference. And that's what it's going to take. Every single one of us. Not just me, not just Mr. Dent. Everyone.
Right. Of course.
Old families like ours should flock together, you know. Like birds.
You're preaching, dear.
No, it's true. The Waynes and Zellerbachs are reminders of the golden age of Gotham.
This city's luster faded years ago, Mr. Dent. Look at Gotham now. Murder in the streets, corruption in City Hall, that Cape Bat Freak dealing out vigilante justice like it's the wild goddamn West.
Oh, Bobby, regarding golden age, seems you're getting cranky in yours. There's always hope.
Forgive me for being blunt, but one man can't save this city. And it's a dangerous mentality to think so. That's how you get creeps like this Batman, or whatever it's called.
I'd say it all depends on the man. Sometimes you need a person who will go off script.
Such as dressing up in a bat costume?
And taking out the criminals who ruin our city. Though the cape may be a bit much.
Don't worry, though. I am not doing this alone. And with Bruce's help, we're replacing the dangerously unsecure Arkham Asylum with a state-of-the-art mental health facility to help Gotham's most at-risk individuals. It will be dedicated to Thomas and Martha Wayne in the hopes that their fate will never be repeated.
Huh. After all your parents did for this city, oh, to be killed in a botched robbery in some alleyway, it was terrible. Truly terrible.
What the f-
yeah, tragedy like that at such a young age must have been crippling.
If only that deranged man had gotten the right treatment, maybe. Well, I don't like to think about maybes, and I'm sure you don't either.
Yes, well, that was a long time ago. I've moved on.
Of course.
Together,
We'll help the whole city move on.
Well, that was a depressing fucking conversation.
I pictured that going.
Right now, I'm picturing another drink.
You know, I was kind of hoping you would mention my campaign, or at least my name. And now I'm picturing that drink, too. Oh, well, hello.
Let me guess.
Harvey Dent.
Selena Kyle.
And eager to know you.
Vicky Vale.
Oh.
Not interested. And reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
This is a private fundraiser, Miss Vale. No reporters allowed.
Well, you don't mind if I stay and ask a few questions, do you, Mr. Wayne?
Well, you can ask me whatever you want at the press conference tomorrow.
Actually, I'm here for Mr. Wayne.
Well, he certainly doesn't have any time either.
Tonight is strictly off the record. We can talk, but nothing gets written down.
I'm okay with that. I was just hoping to see what makes Bruce Wayne tick. This is quite the social event, Mr. Wayne.
Oh, come on now. So formal. Call me Bruce.
Well, Bruce, you've been going around pleasing everyone tonight. But how are you doing?
What the fuck?
You should enjoy your own party before all the champagne runs out.
Well, I'm doing better now that you're here. I'll tell you, if all these stuffed shirts weren't around, I'd give you the private tour.
Oh my god!
Mr. Wayne, you've got something on your collar. Is that blood? Yeah. It looks like...
Oh, this? No, that's nothing. It just, cut myself shaving.
What, your butler didn't help you this time? Hey, kidding. Kidding.
Do excuse me, Master Bruce, but another guest has arrived.
I'm sure they'll find the bar.
You may want to greet this one personally, sir.
Oh, dear.
Carmine Falcone? Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Falcone's never been convicted of anything except being a businessman who loves this city.
Really?
Excuse us, Miss Vale.
Ho, ho, ho.
And what kind of business do you think he's in?
The one that controls enough votes to get me into City Hall. This is the necessary evil of politics, Bruce. It's in the service of a better Gotham, for all of us. Look, at least hear him out before you kick him out. Falcone requested to speak with you directly.
Jesus, Harvey, inviting a known criminal to your fundraiser doesn't exactly look good for your squeaky clean image.
Yeah, seriously.
Let me worry about that. A word of warning, Bruce? Play nice.
Dude, you're putting me in the line of fire.
Looking for a new house? Decent walk-up, sky-high ceilings, plenty of room for my cars? I think I'll take it. Though the decor offends my eyes. Man, all flash, no class.
Well, you couldn't afford it.
Yeah, right. Carmine Falcone, thank you for welcoming me into your home.
Yeah, this is a...
You're a respectable man, I hear.
No, fuck you, dude.
Gentlemen, perhaps we'll all be more comfortable in the parlor. Follow me, if you will.
I've got an image to maintain, too, Dent.
You should know, Mr. Falcone, my analysts say we're raising triple what Mayor Hill has... Hey, what's...
Private audience.
Oh, come on, guys. Bruce?
You'll be fine out there, Harvey. I saw plenty of skirts to keep you busy for a few minutes.
Harvey stays with us.
A man's home is his castle. I respect that. Seen and not heard.
Whatever you...
What did I say?
Huh. Yeah, need
Mr.
witnesses.
The district attorney here wants to make sure the rules are followed.
Yeah, help yourself,
but
cunt.
In my experience, there's the law, and there's doing what's right. You understand?
And I'd rather see Harvey actually help this city instead of just saying he will. The man talks too much. Chaps my face with words.
Well, I would say you can uphold the law and still do what's right.
To a point. No one gets remembered for staying in the middle.
Mr. Falcone, I...
No more warnings. I ain't here to chinwag about politics, Mr. Wayne. Gives me indigestion. I got enough of that as is. So, let's talk relationship.
It would never work, sweetheart.
Chalk this for me. Be a pal.
What the fuck?
I can get Harvey the mayor's seat. Or I can pull it out from under him.
Let's play the game for now.
Okay, imagine. This is me. And these are all my friends in Gotham. The businesses, restaurants, clubs, docks, unions, politicians. I make them all move. And I want to keep everything moving if Harvey gets elected. That's why I came here tonight to your lovely home. Hoping to make a new friend. One who can help Mr. Dent see the light. If need be. Between your businesses and mine, I bet we employ half the city. Now, we got a good thing going, so I don't see why we shouldn't team up. For Gotham. For our city.
Let's stay quiet.
You listen to me, kid. I know somewhere inside that tuxedo you understand this situation. Money gets money. The risks, the alliances, the hidden costs. Your father knew which hands to shake. And which to break.
Whatever you say.
You're a good kid. You look like him, you know? It's nice that we understand each other.
Master Bruce, your guests are leaving. I recommend seeing them out. You wouldn't want to be rude.
Hey, I appreciate the hospitality, Mr. Wayne. But I don't think I'll put an offer on the house. A nice guy like you should have a nice place to live. I'll be seeing you, Bruce, while this city's still standing.
Let's just tow along for now and see what happens. Wow, all of that was the introduction, huh? That was something.
Me.
I wonder what episode it is.
Accusations hold any water with the voters?
Okay. So Kayla's been trying to get my attention. So give me one moment. Let me go see what she wants. That was a really long segment there. Okay, so apparently the computer.
Random stabbings are the latest headache for the riders of Gotham's overcrowded skyrail cars to contend with. Gotham police are investigating.
So as in previous videos, I'm gonna blaze through these here for now. If you want to read them, just hit pause and read whatever's going on here. I mean, this probably isn't gonna tell me. This really isn't going to tell me anything I don't already know.
Bringing the total number of escapees from the half-prison, half-mental hospital to 15 this year. Only 3 have been caught to date, but all the escapees...
So what's interesting is that these are written like a journal, almost. Like, one day I may need to find out what she knows. So it's written from Bruce's perspective. Labeled douchebag.
Mayor Hill's Gotham Beautiful Act takes effect today, making it possible for landlords to evict tenants immediately and without cause. The new law was created in order to allow Gotham.
Whoop, wrong button. Oh, not exit. How the fuck do I get out of here then?
Modify and improve the city's aging buildings.
Oh, here we go. So what's this? Pressures mayor to decry vigilantes.
And if you can believe it, now you can't even trust the valet.
Gotham District Attorney Harvey Dent calls upon the mayor's office to take a public stand against the wave of vigilante action sweeping the streets. Mayor Hill cannot expect the DA's office to prosecute cases on any criteria other than the law. Well, I don't want to keep talking over whatever's going on down here, so...
The rumors of Hill's connections to some of Gotham's most notorious mafia families are true. We don't need another gangster running the city. We need a crime-fighting hero. With over 200 successful convictions, District Attorney Harvey Dent just might be the hero Gotham needs. But he can't save our city alone. He needs your help. He believes that together we can make a dent in Gotham's crime. It starts with you.
Wow, that's awful.
Vote for Harvey Dent and elect a real crime fighter to Gotham's mayoral seat.
I'm Harvey Dent, and I approve this message.
So I don't want to keep talking over the news broadcast, so... Read through this if you can. If I go too fast, just hit pause.
Or will it be perceived as a desperate attempt from a flailing campaign to take down one of Gotham's most promising young politicians?
And in other news, we are now on day 3 of the factory fire that will not end. Crews have given up trying to combat the blaze at the Otisburg Processing Center, owned by Ace Chemical. Still no word on what started the fire, but whatever's burning in there has resisted everything the fire department has thrown at it. They're recommending people avoid the area and seek immediate treatment if you happen to breathe in any of that tar black smoke.
And one mobster's murder caused quite a headache for commuters this morning. The body of Falcone family...
Okay, we're on a loop now.
...Pistachio Garmone was found hanging off the side of the 4th Street Bridge sometime just before dawn.
causing traffic to... All right, cops cut him down. Oh, that highlights everything. That's neat. I wonder if that button exists in the other one. Or in all the other games.
Building for this?
Bats computer!
Let's find out what was so important.
Manor has 7 bedrooms, 2 kitchens, a library, a gymnasium, a basketball court, and a movie theater. And yet I always find you here. In a dark, damp cave. In front of a computer.
I'm more at home here than the rest of the house, you know that.
Then we should build an 8th bedroom down here.
Sure, I can see the headlines now. Bruce Wayne, billionaire, entrepreneur, cave dweller.
Quite an eclectic resume. Did you find out what that, Catwoman tried to steal?
In the process.
What are we looking at?
Let me try a different angle.
Whoa! Alright. This is gonna wreak havoc with the stream that Gubbins is watching. So what am I supposed to be doing exactly?
This is a map of the East Side shoreline. But it could mean any number of things. Money, weapons, drugs, everything flows through that port.
Maybe it's where Mayor Hill picks up his dry cleaning.
Can't make sense of it yet. There's still plenty of files to decrypt.
And in the meantime, I saved you what I could.
Thanks, Al.
Yeah, the same couldn't be said for the bar. I had to literally pry Mrs. Zeller back away. But you'll be pleased to hear everyone has left, including Mr. Falcone. I would have been tempted to be far less polite. I'd recommend leaving the fist fights to your alter ego. Bloodstains are much harder to remove from a tuxedo.
It was a keep your enemies closer situation.
Hopefully not close enough to stab you in the back. For the record, your father despised men like Falcone, thought they ruined Gotham's stellar reputation.
Back when it still had one?
It can again, Bruce. Though people like this Catwoman aren't helping. Is she new to town?
Never seen her before. Hopefully, she's just a tourist. I don't know, I already checked the codex.
Not much to find, apparently.
A few burglaries, break-ins. Seems to lay pretty low.
You could learn a thing or two from her. You can't step outside without it ending up in the news lately. As Bruce or Batman.
I stay out of sight when I need to.
Define need to.
Whenever Harvey calls. The guy's exhausting.
Well, after the press conference tomorrow, I'll mark your calendar as exhausted then. The media isn't good for anyone's health. I don't mean to beat a dead argument, but...
No one's gonna figure it out now. Trust me.
Miss Vale noticed your injuries, so did Mr. Dent. If they put it together with the incident at the mayor's office, it would undo all the long nights and close calls we've endured to get here. You're in the spotlight more than ever. You have to be careful.
I have a job to do, okay? A responsibility to this city. You know why I do this.
For the car, I presume.
Well, the car helps.
Oh, yes, you drive that thing like a bat out of hell. Old men worry, that's all. It's our gift and our curse. One more worry for the list.
I thought I saw Oz. It's been, what, 20 years? Last time I saw him, we were in grade school.
Indeed. You two were thick as thieves. Oswald, however, took that role more literally than you.
Dishonorable discharge, illegal boxing matches, arms dealing, prison stints?
That's a criminal grand slam, if I'm using the expression correctly.
Unfortunately, you are.
Oswald claimed he only wanted to catch up, but his behavior following his family's collapse is troubling. Why he's returning now, I haven't the faintest idea.
Do you think he might know something about the break-in? This Catwoman shows up around the same time Oswald comes back to town. Might not be a coincidence.
Oswald's crimes, numerous they may be, are on a much smaller scale than robbing City Hall.
Well, he was always trouble growing up, but he's the fun kind of trouble.
You both were. Even though you and young Master Cobblepot used to be close, I'd advise you to be cautious. But I know you can't abandon a good mystery until it's solved.
I'll be careful.
Seriously?
When you see what's become of his park, I think you will.
Oswald Cobblepot? So this is like early in the whole Batman saga then. I mean, Dent hasn't evolved. Apparently, Cobblepot hasn't. He doesn't know who Catwoman is.
Where are you, Oz?
Okay, so Love and Gore said something to me about the stream being dead, so I'll be back here in a second. Okay, yeah, so my really shitty internet connection killed the broadcast. On the other hand, it should mean that the game itself will run a little bit better. So, invisible wall, invisible wall. Doobie doobie doo. I missed what that said. Wayne, what? God damn it! Can I go into the codex and look at it or something? No. Can't get to the codex from here. Alright. So I'm playing, I just started playing Game of Thrones as well, which is another Telltale game, if you're not familiar. And, playing these two concurrently, like, this one looks so much better than that one does. Like, the art and the animation and everything in Game of Thrones is actually kind of ugly. This one looks fucking spectacular. Look at these colors! I mean, everything is so vibrant and just pretty. Give that man change.
Thank you, sir.
Seems like the Bruce Wayne thing to do. Maybe you shouldn't come out in, like, your $600 loafers and your slacks and your, I'm going to assume, imported silk shirt.
Statue, but no Oz.
digging the pink mohawk.
Isn't what it used to be.
Hmm. Wonder if I should be taking notes on the graffiti here.
Watch wallet cash. This goes through you. Hey, you heard him, man. The hell are you waiting for? Huh?
You're making a mistake.
You already made one coming here. The next one kills you. End him.
Gentlemen!
Oz.
Keep walking, all right? This don't concern you, twerp!
You see, that's where you're mistaken. My old mate and I have some catching up to do. And you're ruining the moment! Come here! You think that'll do?
Yo! Yo!
This is my park! Mine! You hear that? Oh, hey, Bruce. You've got a little, Yeah, good as new. Woo! That was the right little scrap, eh? Nothing kickstarts the system like a dash of adrenaline, eh? Besides, someone needed to deal with the rubber situation here.
Well, thanks for the backup.
I yanked you away from your bloody ivory tower, Bruce. Least I can do is make sure you don't get shanked.
Oh, that's very thoughtful of you.
It's been, what, 2 decades?
And you know what? I haven't been mugged once that entire time.
That wasn't why I brought you here, mate. Right now, I am trying to recognize the little Bruce I used to run around this place with. Back when it wasn't, you know, like this. This park used to mean something. A place that was safe for kids, for families. People came from all over to visit. Oh, Mom and Dad, they put so much work in here.
Well, those were better days.
That they were, yeah. Thought we'd grow up to be kings, I did. Both of us. This city chews right through people. Mum committed to Arkham. Dad ended it yourself, he did. My family's fortune. There's nothing left, Bruce.
I know. Alfred told me.
It's funny, huh? Same place that ground my family to dust. Gave you the good life. Used to run in the same circles we did. Hobnobbing parties, round-the-world vacations, unlimited potential. Now all I got is this park.
I'm sorry, Oz. No one should have to go through that.
Thanks, Bruce. But we are not the only ones suffering. Good to know you haven't changed, Bruce. You still care about something more than just yourself. Although, I was surprised to see Carmine Falcone at your party last night. Made himself right at home. That oily...
Falcone was an uninvited guest. That's it. never want to see his face again.
On that, we can agree in earnest. Valcone made a stack of cash and corpses a mile high, ruining families like mine. All he needs is a little push. And it'd be a treat to watch him hit pavement. Sorry, mate. This reunion got a lot more grim than I planned. Things are gonna be on the upswing soon, no? A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door. And I'm here to let it in. Which brings me to you, Bruce. You see, you throw a rock in any direction, you break a window that Wayne Enterprises owns. As the rich and powerful go, oh, you top Gotham's list. But when my revolution starts, we're gonna smash windows and cross off names all the way down. Like I said, it's not gonna be pretty. It's gonna be beautiful.
I'm not your enemy, Oz.
That remains to be seen, don't it? I've got great affection for you, Bruce. I really do. Which is why I'm warning you. When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side. Good seeing you, Bruce, but I got some rocks to collect. Cheers.
I like the coat. Showing up in my Infernus.
Mr. Wayne, over here, right here.
This way.
Bruce, Bruce.
Good morning, everyone. Morning, Mr. Dent.
Hey, Bruce, you mind if we swap cars?
I mean, mine isn't fast and the paint's rusting off, but boy, does she have charm. We didn't bring you all out here to discuss cars, honestly. Now, we're here about Arkham Asylum. Ever since it opened its doors, Arkham has been a breeding ground for the criminally insane. Its methods for rehabilitation, crude. Its security, lacking. And worse still, those who do get out, or God forbid, escape, are even more dangerous than before they went in. Arkham Asylum is a cancer on Gotham. But today, with a sizable contribution from this man here, we break ground on a state-of-the-art mental health care facility. One that will improve the well-being of Gotham and its citizens for years to come. Now, Mr. Wayne has a few words he'd like to say. Bruce?
My parents loved Gotham. They invested their blood, sweat and tears in this city. You know, when I was 9 years old, my parents took me to see a movie about a hero in a mask. It was a hero who stood up to oppression and defended the people from injustice, no matter the cost. That night, my parents paid the ultimate cost defending me from a man who needed the kind of help this new facility will provide. With this facility and our next mayor, we create a new face for Gotham.
Today, on the anniversary of that fateful night, we dedicate this facility to Thomas and Martha Wayne and usher in a new era of healing for Gotham.
I'm sure you all have plenty of questions about the new hospital, so let's open it up.
Right here, please.
You first, Miss Vale.
Thank you. With the opening of this new hospital, what does this mean for Arkham Asylum? What happens to the old building?
We should tear down the walls and erase it from the map. I don't want us lingering on past mistakes. I want us to focus on Gotham's future. All right, who's up next?
Mr. Wayne, over here.
You there.
Mr. Wayne, Julia Remark of the Tribune. My sources say you welcomed alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone into your home. You and Mr. Dent even spoke with him behind closed doors.
I don't make friends with gangsters. He was an unwelcome guest. That's all. Next question, please.
Please, keep your questions on topic, people. We're here about the hospital, remember?
But Mr. Wayne, this morning the Globe received evidence of an offshore bank account managed by Carmine Falcone and your father, Thomas Wayne.
What exactly are you implying?
Transactions connected to organized crime, going back years, and continuing to this day. The paper trail ties your family directly to the mob. Care to comment?
And did anyone else receive this evidence?
The Globe, the Gazette, we all did. Mr. Wayne, Mr. Wayne, is all your money dirty?
Is the Wayne family legacy built on lies?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
What are you telling us?
Does the mob sign Wayne Enterprises paychecks?
Yeah, we're gonna stay quiet on that one.
Everyone, please settle down. I'll be fielding your questions from here on out. Please, let's try to keep this civilized.
Bruce, I've been trying to reach you. The police are inside the manor.
Gee, I can't imagine about what. Commissioner Gordon, I presume. Can I help you?
Hey, careful. Put it back.
I'm afraid we can, Mr. Wayne.
Says who?
This warrant. It's not personal. I had the boys turn the lights off, keep a low profile.
I understand. You're just doing your job, Lieutenant.
Oh, he's not even commissioner.
It's hard to be a cop in this city. Every battle's uphill, in the rain, with skates on.
Alfred, keep an eye on them. Make sure they only take what they have to.
Of course, sir.
Why does Gordon sound like J. Jonah Jameson?
I meant what I said about not personal. We only want files related to Wayne Enterprises. The warrant covers your place, pardon me, places of residence, and any companies you own. Your holdings are extensive.
And what do you expect to find?
That's for our analysts back at the precinct to figure out. I can't comment. It's a valid warrant. I gotta serve it. Mayor Hill signed off on this himself.
Of course he did.
As long as he's mayor, he calls the shots.
Well, Hill has a history of making his opposition disappear.
Rumors and allegations, Mr. Wayne, that's all. But if they become fact, I'll handcuff him myself, same as any other crook. I don't know how your neck ended up on Mayor Hill's shopping block, but here we are.
Hill knows if I go down, Harvey's campaign goes down too.
That'd be a real shame. Mr. Dent's the only DA I ever trusted to make a conviction stick. As mayor, I think he can finally turn things around for us. For all our sakes, I pray you've got nothing to hide.
Yeah, that was a difficult set of dots to connect. What the fuck did you just do? Oh, no way. Is that like a nice picture of my parents or something? Hey, fuckstick!
To do this.
So this seems to be an origin story of some sort. Which makes me wonder how many of these are going to be coming out in the future.
Bruce?
Who the fuck let you in?
I didn't mean to interrupt, but...
This is the second time you've shown up uninvited.
Well, it's difficult to book a meeting with you.
Well, I enjoy my privacy.
Enjoyed. Past tense.
Ooh.
Sorry, but if the press has their way, you're not gonna have any for a while. Listen, Bruce. A scandal surrounding a beloved family like yours captures the public's attention. I can help you get the right kind of attention. Through my connections at the Gazette, I have all kinds of access. I can dig up whatever you need to fight this.
What's your angle?
Not all reporters just want a headline. Some of us are old-fashioned. I still want the truth. The Gazette received this supposed evidence like every other media outlet, and it's all hearsay. Flimsy sources. There isn't a shred of hard proof.
Still, allegations like this, they don't magically appear. Someone is going after my family. After me.
Obviously, the sender didn't identify themselves. We have no idea who it could be. I mean, no one's even done their due diligence on this yet. The press saw the fumble, they grabbed the ball and ran. Not every day you get to go after a Wayne.
Hill wants me out of the picture because with my backing, Harvey wins in a landslide. All signs point to Hill.
You're a kingmaker, Mr. Wayne. And Harvey Dent is Gotham's knight in shining armor just waiting for the crown. You're the first target on Hill's list. By tonight, this scandal will be broadcast to every screen in Gotham. Everyone will be talking about it.
This isn't my first pass through the rumor mill. I know the damage it can do.
Then go on the record. Right here, right now, and stop it. You need to get out ahead of this. Your side is what matters, not wild speculation.
On the record, then.
Whenever you're ready.
Whoever fabricated these lies about my family, they will get what they deserve. Understood?
That's exactly what the people of Gotham need to hear.
Justice.
You're gonna beat this, Bruce. The Waynes always come out on top.
Goodbye, Miss Rail.
I hate to admit it, but everyone smells smoke. A fire is heading this way.
Batman has made plenty of enemies, but my family... We've done nothing but support Gotham, even in its darkest days.
All this on the anniversary of your parents?
Not a coincidence. Harvey's the district attorney. He should have told me this was coming.
Then find out why he didn't.
Warrant? What the hell's going on? Wait, does this have to do with what the reporters were talking about this morning? That press conference turned into a bloodbath.
I'm in a lot of trouble, Harvey, and I need your help to get me out of it.
Yes, of course. Of course, whatever I can do. Mayor Hill authorized this?
Yeah. Then the cops raid my house, taking everything related to Wayne Enterprises. Computers, hard drives, files.
Oh, son of a bitch.
You're the goddamn DA, Harvey.
I didn't know about this. I swear. Hill totally blindsided me on this one. God damn it. He has no right to issue search warrants without my okay.
Okay, I believe you, Harvey. Mayor Hill's trying to screw us both over with this move.
And then he's made two enemies. I just don't get it. Why would Hill stick his neck out over this? Just to tangle you up in some frivolous investigation? It just doesn't make sense.
I mean, what could he possibly hope to accomplish other than a few cheap headlines?
It's got to be politically motivated. Hill can't match your fundraising, so he's trying to take out your biggest donor.
I don't know. This is a new low, even for Hill. Oh, God, what a mess. Bruce, I wish I could just make this go away, but I'm not sure if I can. If I get in the way of this investigation, Hill would be able to spin it as a conflict of interest. And that wouldn't be good for either of us. It would jeopardize the entire campaign.
You should probably distance yourself from me.
What? No, no, I can't do that.
Well, you may have to.
Don't say that. You...
There you are.
Hey, you.
Sorry, I got a habit of being late.
Oh, shit.
Glad you made it.
Now that's Selena Kyle. Oh, that wasn't difficult to figure out. God.
Tell me you were bringing a friend to dinner.
This is Selena.
Sure it is.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
Just election nonsense.
I think we've met before.
You do look familiar.
Everyone knows who Bruce Wayne is.
Do they?
Pleasure to meet you, Miss...
Kyle.
Shit.
It's a strong grip you've got there. Don't worry. I'm not gonna fall.
Oh, right. Sorry.
Selena's new to town. I've been showing her around Gotham, introducing her to people.
You're an excellent tour guide, Harv.
Well, if I lose the election, I guess I can drive one of those double-decker tour buses around town.
Meet anyone interesting?
The games we play.
They haven't all been as welcoming as Harv. I was mugged. I'm just angry I let that masked freak get away with all my stuff.
I still can't believe I let you walk home alone. I should have called you a car.
It's not your fault.
Did you at least get a look at the guy?
Good enough to make an ID.
I'll get Gordon down to GCPD to work on a lineup. That's probably long gone by now, whatever that idiot took.
I hope not. These were important materials.
Oh, sensitive?
Very. I don't know how I'm going to explain this to my client. When things like this happen in my line of work, people tend to overreact.
We should just be thankful you got away with a black eye.
So, what do you do for a living?
It's complicated. High risk, high reward.
Ah, stock market, huh?
Something like that. At least I'm not the only one who's taken a beating. That press conference? Oof.
We've got it under control.
Do you?
I'll handle it. Someone at my office has to know what's going on. Excuse me a moment.
This conversation's gonna be fun.
Explains a lot, actually. How you can afford the fancy armor, the toys. Wouldn't Harvey be surprised? Not to mention everyone in this cafe.
Sorry about the black eye.
It's not the first time a man's hit me.
Sorry to hear that.
Don't worry. I'm not gonna expose you. Yet. I'm curious about something, though. I do what I do for money, but you're... Bruce Wayne. What's your excuse? I have to. But you... Why take the risk?
I don't need one. I do this... because I can.
And I thought you were on some noble crusade against crime. Silly me. You have something that belongs to me. I want it back. This is awkward for me. I'm used to robbing people, not the one being robbed.
As I recall, you took something from me, too. Hope you're getting some use out of that grappling gun.
I'm more interested in how I can use you.
Giggity.
These people I'm working for, they don't screw around. If I fail to deliver that drive, it's gonna cost a lot more than money.
Well, looks like you've made your bed.
No, we've made this bed, and I'm not gonna lie in it alone.
Giggity.
You owe me. If they don't get what they want, there will be consequences. I don't like consequences.
All right, you want my help? You got it. What can I do?
You can give me back the drive.
Not possible.
Listen, I don't have a lot of time. My employer is expecting me to drop it off.
Where?
Just give it back.
The address, now.
No, give me the drive.
You're just going to have to trust me.
I don't do trust. I guess I'm screwed either way. My contact, he'll be expecting a cat, not a bat.
When are you supposed to meet him?
15 minutes ago. Better hurry.
Everything okay here?
You tell me.
I have my people working on it. We're gonna straighten everything out.
I feel better already.
You sound fucking relieved, Bruce.
Sorry, but I've gotta run.
So soon? Aren't you gonna stay for a drink?
Yeah, Bruce. Stay for a drink?
I'd love to, but I've got another appointment and I really don't want to be late for it.
Oh, all right then. And don't forget to change into your suit.
Oh, aren't you clever little bitch? Is that the East Docks? Like where the,
Alfred, I'm at the warehouse. No sign of Catwoman's contact. It's quiet.
The sound of an ambush. Stay on guard.
Well, you are over like an hour late. Holy shit! What's up with the White Rose?
This wasn't a handoff. It was a massacre.
How many?
I'd have to count the pieces.
Oh, good lord.
Explosion.
Such a thing.
That's what I'm gonna find out.
Gordon, Eastside Docks, Warehouse 133.
Oh, he turned on the bat voice. Check that out.
Analyzing. It's a volatile chemical. Potential psychoactive nerve agent. Vile stuff.
Be very, very careful with that. Who knows what effect it may have?
Have the computer catalog the compound for further analysis.
As you wish.
Nothing left to bury. No.
Oh, okay. That's interesting.
Whatever exploded did so with enough force to obliterate the person standing next to it. But the chemicals themselves were inert, non-explosive.
Well, it appears to have made a pretty big boom.
I'll see what I can piece back together.
Yeah, see, this is the detective shit I was really excited to do. That was pretty fucking cool. Okay, so now we've got links here. Let's see here. Let's look up top first. Because I bet there's something weird going on here. We'll get to the White Rose in a second. Burnt cop.
This man's been badly burned. the damage seems to originate from inside his skull. What did this?
Interesting. No! I don't know what I'm doing here. Okay, here we go.
Sensors say it's an incendiary round.
Oh.
Phosphorus residue. This could have superheated the contents of the canister,
causing the aforementioned boom.
Blood, broken nails, bits of human flesh. No.
That bad?
Face slashed, throat torn open.
So, not natural causes then?
Skylight Club. A cop shredded this merc to pieces, barehanded. The nerve agent could make them psychotic. White Rose. Falcone's calling card.
Oh.
He's been busy as of late.
Send the drones hunting. I want to know his every move.
Good thinking, sir.
I hope I get to examine everything
it's
here.
A cop. The force grows thinner every day. Canisters were stored here. Canisters of what? I've seen these outfits before. Same mercs that broke into City Hall. The canister exploded, sending shrapnel right through the container door.
For once, I'm glad you arrived after the heist. Your armor wouldn't have protected you against that.
Let's link that to over here.
Don't think so. No proof.
Okay, so I can't come to false conclusions, it looks like. Come on. destroyed much?
Looks like a bullet started this.
A normal bullet couldn't have caused that explosion.
Doesn't appear normal. The point of entry's melted.
Do-to-do-to-do-to-do-to-do. Way over here. So we're only gonna have two point links at the moment.
Find a connection.
The bullet that killed the cop is the same type that blew up the canister.
I'm sure they didn't find that at the local gun store.
It appears military.
I don't have anything else to link to. Wait, what if I do? Oh.
Something was here when the explosion occurred.
Yeah.
Someone drove off after the explosion.
You're a regular fucking Sherlock on that one.
Yes. Falcone leaving his rose here. This is a message. Dead cops, stolen chemicals. He's making a big move. One of his snipers hit a canister with an incendiary bullet, causing it to superheat and explode. This may have been a distraction or a way of destroying evidence. Cops moved in to stop the theft. Falcone's men gunned them down. Then things turned grim. Possibly due to the psychoactive nerve agent, a cop ripped up a merc's face with his bare hands. And was put down. Same sniper, same type of bullet. Looks like Falcone's men got what they wanted and escaped.
Have you located the shooter?
No, but based on two impact trajectories, the canister and the dead cop, the shooter could only have a clear shot from there, there, or there. And would have contaminated himself with the phosphorus residue. Program the skimmers to pick up that signature.
Right away, sir.
I'm gonna check over here first. Hey, check it out.
Phosphorus spike. Clear vantage point. We have a winner.
Hey, look at that. First try. Go me.
This is the right spot. So where did he go?
Gee. Real fucking difficult to figure that one out. Maybe out the goddamn window, Batman?
Trace stops here.
Then he should be nearby.
Found him. Time to go to work. Your corpse to this graveyard.
Balcony, why did he do this?
I ain't telling you nothing! You can't make me talk! I ain't telling you, Jack! You trying to scare a confession out of me? I won't break!
Your bones will.
It's true what they said about you. You're a freaking animal.
Time to live up to my reputation. You know, you can bleed to death without ever spilling a drop. All on the inside. Tell me the plan, or I start swinging.
If you're gonna hit me, hit me!
All right.
Tell me.
That cab woman was supposed to hand over a drive, had the container number we needed, but she flaked. So we had to find it ourselves. Container by container. Someone must have heard us call the cops. We were told no witnesses.
Why risk open war with the GCPD?
Some kind of chemicals. Falcone wanted them.
What are the chemicals for?
We were paid to steal them, not ask questions.
I start here and keep breaking until you answer.
The chemicals! There's some kind of explosive. A weapon. I don't know. Falcone said he'd use them soon.
Used where?
That's all I know. I swear. I told you everything I know. You're an animal. I was just here for a pickup.
You'll never hold a gun steady again.
Oh, God.
Jesus Christ. These are cops. Get an ambulance in here!
I think I need to call the coroner instead. It's Montoya. Send a cleanup unit to the docks.
Let's GTFO.
I was wrong. Gonna need that ambulance too. The hell's going on tonight, Lieutenant?
That man.
J. Jonah Gordon here.
You're taking this too far, Bruce. You assume the persona of a bat, but you're not an animal. You nearly killed a man tonight. Your parents didn't raise you this way. And neither did I.
He's still alive, isn't he?
And in the hospital. Next time, it might be the morgue. Especially now, during this preposterous attack on your family. You must show the world the true nature of a Wayne.
Giving everything to the city and then being murdered for it?
My thoughts exactly. Every time you leave this cave. You're a good man, Bruce. Good. Just like your parents. Don't lose that. I don't mean to be a doddering old fool on the subject, but as a friend, the burden of advice falls on me.
Sometimes this job requires hard decisions.
You're the right man to make them. In fact, I think you're the only one who can. You bury the person, Bruce, but you never bury the memory.
Sometimes I wish I could. That night, that alleyway, it made me who I am. I can't get it out of my head.
That is your gift and your curse. Being Batman can allow you to turn back the tide of treachery that's reached this city's shores, or drown you in its sorrow. When you doubt your fate, remember why you started all this. Remember that boy in the alley.
I won't forget.
Neither will I. Well, back into the fray again.
Okay, let's take a look at the codex quick. Okay, so now I can scroll down. Oh, guess I can't escape out of that menu. Catwoman. What? Why can't I go? Oh, this is my scroll bar. I'm dumb. So anyway, okay, so there's the, and Gordon. I did do that, though. Huh. Corruption rumors tarnish Wayne family legacy. That would be a blow. Oh yeah, there's nothing else talking now. So, the Waynes have long been considered one of Gotham's most respected families, but new allegations have tied family patriarch Dr. Thomas Wayne and his wife Martha to the illegal business dealings of the Falcone crime family. If true, it's possible the Wayne family's staggering a fortune, estimated to be in the billions, could be seized by authorities pending an investigation into their current business practices. That would be a blow to heir Bruce Wayne, who has continued his father's practice of using the money for philanthropy. It's a good thing that he's a philanthropist and not a full-on rapist, you know? However, Dr. Wayne met a violent end as the victim of a random street crime 2 decades ago. While there has been no comment on the allegations from Wayne, he did hold a private meeting with Falcone crime family head Carmine Falcone at the Wayne family's... I did give a quote! What the fuck, game? Tangles with Max Crook atop City Hall. Daring raid on the City Hall office ended last night with a massive rooftop brawl between Batman and a masked cat burglar the police have dubbed Catwoman. The battle resulted in a heart-stopping plunge off the side of the building, which left Catwoman's fate unclear. However, her team of mercenaries were apprehended by authorities. Her team of mercenaries! Neither the GCPD nor representatives of the Hill administration have revealed what, if anything, was stolen from the mayor's office. Despite the outcome, many have begun to wonder if Batman let the burglar go free. We can't outsource our safety to anonymous people in disguise, said Gotham Police Commissioner Peter Grogan. You can never trust whose side they're really on. Did I read everything in here? I did. I think. Wow, this scroll's really slow. Alright. So... Alright. Bat's computer!
Looks like that egg finally cracked. And inside, Mayor Hill was hiding... more than I could have imagined. This is a complete manifest of Carmine Falcone's criminal organization.
What in the world was Hill doing with all this? He
illegal arms dealing, drug running, mob hits, money laundering. Falcone's been involved in everything.
This is an insurance policy. Hill could expose Falcone if he didn't play along.
That would explain why he's never made a move against him.
Sure as hell better than any bodyguard. This is it, Alfred. With this proof, we can finally knock out Falcone's organization.
Where would we possibly begin to dismantle it?
This is a police matter.
There's only one cop we can trust to handle this evidence correctly.
Lieutenant Gordon. He could mobilize the entire police force against Falcone.
What about that reporter from the Gazette?
Vicky.
Yes, Ms. Vale. She could release this evidence through proper channels. I suppose it comes down to who you want to help most. Or who you think could do the most good.
That is a good choice. With as corrupt as the police can be, though, I think it's better to give it to Vicky. She can release it through the proper channels, make it public knowledge.
Vicky showed faith in me. She cares about the truth. She'll get the story out the way it needs to be told.
A wise decision, sir. We'll attack Falcone on two fronts tonight. Vicky through the media, and Batman...
by any means necessary. Whatever Falcone is planning... it ends tonight.
He's a spider, Bruce. Eyes everywhere. A dense web of goons poised to trap you. No one has ever managed to bring him down.
I haven't tried yet.
This is big. You drop a bomb like this, there's gonna be fallout.
That not even Falcone can survive.
Why give it to me then? You don't know how much I appreciate it, but you're Wayne. You could have given it to anyone.
I need an ally in the press.
After handing me something like this, I'd say you got one for life. Falcone's slippery, but this is enough to hang him out to dry. What this could do for the city, my career, I'm just wondering what the cost is gonna be.
It'll be worth it.
I don't know, Bruce. Falcone doesn't like bad press. If I run this story, I put a price on my head. The next time my name appears in the media, God, it might be an obituary.
I'll protect you, I promise.
Chivalrous, but unnecessary. You're not Batman.
Oh, ho, ho.
I always think, crime in the city, it's a hydra. You cut off one criminal's head.
Three more appear in its place. I know.
Actually, it's two, Bruce.
We kill the beast once and for all. But who's even capable of that?
Hail Hydra.
If we don't act fast, that void will be filled by someone far worse. Wouldn't be the first time.
Lieutenant Gordon, he has his badge in the right place.
Yeah, well, I hope that's enough. Sometimes the rest of the force, they have their own agenda. It's a good thing you gave this to me instead of the police. Could end up buried in some evidence locker and not on every screen in Gotham where it belongs.
I agree.
Public attention. That's what brings down men like Falcone. Not a bullet.
Though after my story runs, he might get that too. I'll be seeing you, Bruce.
It's done.
Good. So is our hunt. The drones located Falcone downtown, a place called the Skyline Club. Although you're not dressed for that kind of party.
Well, I can always change in the car.
What the fuck? Seriously? radioactive camo Batmobile. What the fuck? Jesus Christ. Oh, that was something else. So I'm guessing this is going to be the climax of this episode. That looks like the hoverboard from the Green Goblin.
Let's find Falcone.
Maneuver the drone around the outside. Okay. Hey, stop it.
Good point of entry.
Okay, so I can go right and I can go up. Oh, nope, nope. Okay, I see the little bar here on the left now. Or right. I don't know my right from my left. Come on, I saw the... Okay.
Tell me another.
What's the difference between the Mafia and City Council?
I don't know. Aren't they the same thing?
Only one of them is organized.
Ooh. You're cute.
So, are you alone?
Not anymore, of course.
Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear.
Where's Nikki? In lockup. Again? Christ, Kimmy. What did they pinch him for now? Some hit down at the docks. Nikki? No. I didn't think he was a hatchet man. You and me both. Well, does he got an alibi? Honey, I'm always his alibi.
You make your rounds?
Yeah,
no broken bones. Still healing from the last time, I bet.
All it took was a couple of C notes this time.
Nice and easy.
Nice and easy, my ass. I know you burned powder tonight. The whole city can smell it.
White
rose. Falcone's symbol.
A red rose after tonight.
Ooh. Someone's going down. Modern art.
Nothing here.
Well, why can't I look at it?
Falcone's hideout.
Well, it won't be as easy as ringing the doorbell.
Four armed guards. Stealth not an option. I'll put together a plan of attack. Stand by.
Yeah, I have a feeling I'm gonna fuck this one up. Okay.
Guy down.
Link thugs to objects on the environment to plan your takedowns. This is going to be interesting. Alright, fine, let's try this. We can just throw him into the coffee table. Oh, okay. You? Hey, come on. Examine. Oh, let's do a different one. Let's go over here to the staircase. That looks like fun. It said 4. There we go. Hanging light, that looks promising. Modern art also looks promising, but I like the light idea. Yeah. So what happens if I try this?
This one might be tricky. Any ideas?
I've got it covered, Al.
I haven't been looking at the furthest from the entry point. I mean, they all have to be possible. I don't like that. I'd rather cut the light down because it's closer. Yeah, since I'm gonna have to like move from right there, so gonna have to do it quick. Distracted and unprepared for action. Should be quickly neutralized. And you. So what's this one? Oh, stealth.
Bruce, have you formulated your plan of attack?
Not yet.
Reactivating drone cameras.
I want to see what the other one is. What happens here? I like the stealth option better. Okay, so we're all set up now, right? Oh, I have to do them all over again? No, okay. So now we're good, right?
Bruce,
Absolutely.
I'm going in.
Very good, sir. Your turn to crash his party.
The irony was not lost on me. Yeah! Ooh! I just casually walk through everybody. I'm confused what the thing in the bottom left-hand corner is. I think it's like a fail gauge. If it runs out, I bet I die or something. So, like, it fills up as I complete actions. Holy shit! Goddamn lunatic?
Show yourself! You got no goddamn right to be here! I run Gotham! Help!
Oh, I thought I was gonna bring the whole balcony down. Oh!
How about this one? You can't sneak up on me.
You'll be armed.
Well, it just did.
Get your goddamn hands off of my suit!
Stay down, Falcone. We can end this now.
You got a lot to learn.
Oh, holy shit. Nice. Yep, that's right.
You've lost, Falcone.
I can go a few more rounds. All right.
The chemicals. Where are they?
What?
I found your calling card at the docks. The White Rose.
You think I wanted to lead you here?
Yeah, I had a feeling about that.
Something reeks about this whole thing. And it is a dead bat.
Still want to play games?
We're all being played here, including you. Those chemicals you're so riled up about, they're mine, all right? But someone is trying to cut me out of the deal because I did not make that mess at the docks.
Then who did?
No, we're done. Gotham's watching now. Go ahead. Give him a show. I'll be walking free by tomorrow morning. Ha! Gotham! Ha! Whoa, wait! What the hell are you?
still can. It's... the Waynes. They're behind all this.
What do you mean?
You really want to take down crime? Well, the Waynes are the biggest gangsters in Gotham.
Interesting.
Smoke could reportedly be seen from street level. Tonight, the Skyline Club, a high-rise mafia hangout in downtown Gotham, was the arena for a clash between the notorious Batman and alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone, who was brutally wounded in the attack.
Oh!
Though I'd say the crime boss getting his is well overdue, Falcone has slipped through the law's grasp for years, but after this dramatic arrest and a stunning expose by Gazette reporter Vicky Vale, Falcone's going away for a long, long time. And speaking of newly uncovered criminal dealings, this brings me to the story everyone is talking about, the Wayne family. For generations, the big W on the Wayne Enterprises Tower was a reassuring sight. You knew that there was something pure at the heart of Gotham. That this city, for all its faults, was built by good people. But with Thomas and Martha's shining reputation called into question, we no longer have such assurances. And even worse, it seems the apple hasn't fallen far from the tree. Gotham's greatest son, Bruce Wayne, seen here in the company of gangsters, may be just as crooked as his parents. In his defense, Wayne fired back saying,
"Whoever fabricated these lies about my family, they will get what they deserve. Understood?"
In a world where the Waynes, our golden family, are corrupt, who are we left with? Who can Gothamites look up to? The monster Batman? Only time will tell. Meanwhile, we'll keep digging for the truth. But the prominent feeling throughout Gotham is that the Waynes' time in the sun is ending.
Oh, the quote that all those things must have been talking about was a quote from the party.
Suit, the car, this entire cave.
Master Bruce?
Everything I built.
I created all of this because I didn't want any more innocent people to die. If Falcone's telling the truth about my parents,
then what the hell did we do this for?
Bruce, I...
What have you been hiding from me? Alfred!
Ho 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 ho! Spine chilling! Alright, so... that's gonna be episode 1 of Batman, a Telltale game series. Realm of Shadows. Did you stick up for Falcone, for Harvey in front of Falcone? I did! Did you provide a quote for Vicky Vale's story? Yep, okay. You broke the dock shooter's arm? Absolutely! That dude is a sniper, he doesn't need to be holding a rifle anymore! Who did you give the data to? I gave it to Vicky instead of the GCPD, which apparently most of the people handed it over to the police. How did Batman deal with Falcone? Absolutely, we brutalized the fuck out of him, because he's an asshole. Okay. Oh, shit. Sorry, I didn't let the... damn it. Okay, my bad, I didn't...
Parents died. They left me as caretaker of their estate, their son, and their secrets. I would never betray them. Your parents. parents were good people, Bruce, no matter what that thug Falcone told you.
Then swear to me, there's no truth to it.
That scoop you brought me on Falcone helped me more than you could possibly know. I owe you one.
I'm sure Falcone's taken harder beatings in the past. Hopefully, this one knocks something useful out of him.
Hell of a view!
Bruce, the Wayne name is toxic. I have to do what's best for my campaign. What's best for Gotham. I have to distance myself. I will find the truth. Along with anyone who stands in my way.
Okay, so I apologize for not letting the credits go to their end. I didn't realize that hitting continue would end that part of it. I just thought it was going through this part of the thing where it tells me all my choices. But anyway, so that's episode one. Fucking awesome! That was fantastic! The combat scenes were vivid. They were fucking volatile. Oh, they were visceral. Oh my god. Dude, the game opened up with a dude catching a bullet to the dome and brain matter being seen. This is going to be a much darker take than a lot of what the comic books have been able to do, than what the movies have been able to do, what even the cartoon movies have been able to do. I'm really excited for this to continue. The music, oh my gods, the music was phenomenal. Fantastic. I had no idea that this was an origin story. So that's even more interesting to me. I like where they're going with it. I want to see how they develop this. You know, I'm not even going to take the, like, since I'm gushing over this episode so much, I'm not even going to take the time to bitch about the illusion of choice mechanics, because they were not nearly as transparent in this game so far as they have been in previous Telltale games. So I'll bitch about that, like, over on the Game of Thrones, videos. But this has been a great experience. It's a fantastic start to this series. I don't know if it's going to be 5 or 6 episodes. Most of them from what I've seen have been 5 episodes. Game of Thrones, though, is 6. So I don't know how long this is going to be. I'm guessing 5. Well, actually, they might have the episodes listed here. Yep, looks like it's going to be 5 episodes. So, okay. Okay. I'm done gushing for now. That was a fantastic experience, and I really hope that you enjoyed it as much as I did. Please, if you did enjoy the content, remember to like and subscribe. This game is currently available. You can get the season pass on Steam for like $25. If you tell me that if you watch this video and you have any interest in this game, go fucking buy it. And here's why. You cannot tell me that you have not spent $25 on something more frivolous. On worse game, like, if you're a gamer, I guarantee it, you've spent $60 on games that are far worse than this. Like, I'm sure some of you bought into the Evolve hype. Some of you bought into the Destiny hype. I bought into the Diablo 3 hype. Eventually, these games get fixed and are not awful. Well, maybe not Battleborn. I hear that one's doing awful. But other games, they get patches and fix them, but it takes time. This is $25. The content so far is amazing. The art in this game is leagues ahead of every other Telltale game that I've seen so far. Not that the art is usually, not that the graphics and everything are usually like a big selling point for these. Like, they usually have like this pseudo like cel-shaded comic book feel, but this one has been fucking gorgeous. Like, it's a real it's a real interesting contrast, since I'm right now I'm also playing the Game of Thrones one, and it's creating this really interesting dichotomy where you see Game of Thrones and this one side by side, and this one just is fucking beautiful and Game of Thrones is kind of lackluster. So there's not a single thing about this game so far that is not good. The voice acting was incredible. Minus the fact that Jim Gordon kind of sounds like J. Jonah Jameson. I didn't even find it that campy that he had the fucking voice modulator. He turned it off and on at times, so you know I can handle that. Cobblepot was really interesting. The guy that's doing Batman is really good. I always get worried about these kinds of things whenever it's not Kevin Conroy, the guy that did the voice in the animated series and in a lot of the animated movies. But the voice actor for Batman was really good. The voice actor for Cobblepot, for Gordon, for Dent, Selina Kyle was fantastic. There's nothing about this game that is not fantastic so far. So please, go out, check it out, buy it. And remember to like and subscribe, share this video, and let people know how awesome this game is. I'm not even worried about getting the more views for the video. Go out and tell people how awesome this fucking game is, and give them this video to watch it. And then, once you've done all of that, make sure that you come back next time to see what would Zig do in Batman: The Telltale Series. I will see you all then.